Does Macarena count as a separate type of dance? What would you call Macarena? Maybe it's just a lineup. Macarena.
Bala tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena, que tu cuerpo pa dar la alegría y cosa buena. Bala tu cuerpo alegría.
Hello, my wonderful subscribers, and of course, Arrasa the Dancer is here. And if you're visiting this channel not for the first time and you are the actual subscriber, then you know that I am a professional salsa and bachata dancer. Now, I have a background of ballroom dancing as well. When I was very little, I started with ballroom and then just so happened life took me to salsa and bachata. And this is basically what I do now all day, all night long. I dance salsa and bachata. But my dancing and the way I dance is defined by many other dances. So this video, I will share to you of what kind of dances actually influences my style in my bachata and salsa. The first biggest credit goes to Bollywood dancing. You might be maybe surprised about this, but some of you who've been following me for a while, you know I love Bollywood dancing. I've been doing it for not that long, maybe a couple of years, but I've been doing it in and out, like through all my dancing career. Now and then, Bollywood would just appear one way or another. And sometimes a bit more traditional, some a little bit more, modern, but it's just so much fun. I love the music, I love the movies, and the dancing is just full of joy, and there's so much flavor into that dancing. And how did it help my salsa and bachata? Well, first of all, Bollywood requires a lot of stamina. Up, down, doom, doom, down, and squat, and press up, and it's all kinds of things. So just the stamina itself, if you do Bollywood, your body is gonna be worked so hard. So then in salsa and bachata, especially in salsa with a lot of speed, it doesn't exhaust me, like ever. If you do Bollywood, you're gonna be just fine when it comes to stamina. And also, of course, there's a lot of like hip-hoppy elements, which is fantastic in isolations for sensual bachata, for example. So I think Bollywood has a huge influence on the way I do my dancing in salsa and bachata. Okay, now, so dance number two is contemporary. Contemporary, I am no expert whatsoever, but I picked up bits and pieces again along the way. What happens is when you are a dancer, professional dancer, you are a professional dancer usually on one particular thing, and then the other things are just something that you do because you love to dance in general, and also because you do want to develop different kinds of skill set with your dancing and be able to create more interesting things. So contemporary, that's how I started contemporary. I dabble in it. I took some classes. I copy all the things that I see, and it's been amazing for flexibility, for balance, and for more lyrical side of dancing. So if I would do sensual bachata, or if I would do salsa romantica, and I want to have a little bit more elegance in my dancing, nice lines, and some fluidity in my movement, kind of more interpretive music, then contemporary definitely comes in help. And especially, as I say, for flexibility in contemporary, there's a lot of lifting the legs up high, splits, and all kinds of things that definitely helps me out in salsa and bachata, especially since I'm used to doing shows. So that helps me out a lot. And I love contemporary as well because it allows me to interpret different kind of music. So I then when I come back to salsa and bachata, I get to hear the music differently as well. I love that. The third dance that I would like to bring up is hip hop and different kinds of versions of it. Now, I don't naturally gravitate to hip hop, and not because I don't love it. I love to watch and I love what it is. It's just, we all have a different kind of music that we prefer listening to, and hip hop, you dance to also different kind of music, right? So as a dancer, I gravitate towards the music, and then that music has different kinds of dances, right, that is associated with. And hip hop has never been my thing, but I started on purpose learning a little bit of hip hop. Not a lot, but a little bit, because I found that because I have ballroom background, I used to be a little bit too stiff. I wouldn't know how to go down into the floor. So when we used to do congresses and lineups, I would always feel like if there's a reggaeton lineup come up or something that I feel like I'm inadequate, because I look very posed and I just look like I don't belong. So just for the sake that I wouldn't feel like any time when somebody would throw me at something, I wanna feel like I'm part of it, right? If I'm a dancer, I'm a dancer. I should be able to do a little bit of everything. So I started doing hip hop because it teaches you how to go a little bit more down into the floor, how to be a little bit down and dirty. And I think that helped me out a lot. And now what I realized, I started using, without even realizing it, I started using some bits into actual classical music and making it a little bit more in the ground rather than up, even with the contemporary as well. So it's very interesting how different dances can shape you and make you create then differently as well. But I, as I say, hip hop is not my thing, but I chosen to do it just because I thought I cannot look like I'm, you know, this ballerina girl doing some reggaeton stuff. So you know how I just said that I was doing hip hop, but it's not my thing? Okay, so it might seem like a little bit of contradiction, but bear with me, I shall explain. I am hugely, hugely influenced all of my dancing by Crump. Now, let me explain. Crump is an angry, what it seems to be a more angry version of hip hop. It has a lot of movement that is expressing your frustration, and it's a little bit more in your face, and it looks a little bit more angry. And I recommend everybody, if you don't know what Crump is, I recommend everybody go to YouTube, check it out. It's mostly dominated by men, and there are a few females as well, but mostly dominated by men. And it's just like, it's crazy. Why am I obsessed by Crump? I have no idea. I love everything about it. It looks angry and it looks big, and I don't know, I love the shapes that they create while they do Crump. So I started doing a little bit. Now, by no means I am no Crump expert, but I am actually, I feel so good when I do Crump. It just makes me feel like an amazing release, and yet it's with a lot of control. And those kind of gestures, I find myself putting more and more of that into my dancing now. And I find that a lot of popular music has bits, especially with dubstep influence, with, you know, computer music influence. There's so much now that you can actually put a little bit of Crump flavor on a lot of the music. Now, not to say the dance itself, but the flavor of it. And I absolutely love it. It just goes to show how, you know, Crump is associated with hip hop. It comes from kind of same family, but it's like Crump I absolutely love. Maybe deep down inside I have anger issues. And finally, tap dancing. I love, 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 love tap dancing. I love the old school tap dancing. I love the freedom of it, but most importantly, I started learning a little bit of tap dancing because of rhythms and the footwork. So the footwork in tap dancing is super intense, and Irish tap dancing as well is super intense. So I wouldn't say that I prefer one or the other or something, but the whole point of learning footwork, kickball change, all kinds of positions and the sounds that you can make with your feet, I believe it helps me a lot with my dancing, Dominican bachata, salsa footwork, you know, the postures and the open arms and everything, a lot of jazz influence. So that is super duper helpful for me. I'm still very, very new at it. As I say, I just dabble to get the flavor and to put it in the stuff that I dance full time. But I love it, and I think it's super beneficial. Any dancer you're going to talk to, or any athlete you're going to talk to, you will see that they do so much more beyond the profession that they hold. If you are a ballet dancer, you probably do some other dancing. If you are a salsa bachata dancer, you probably have background of something else, or you training with something else to get more into your dancing. The learning never stops, right? It's the same as a doctor. You choose who you're going to be slightly later on, but you start learning quite a lot of everything in the beginning. So don't be afraid to try different things. We're all gonna have something that we are better at, and we're gonna always have something we prefer to do. But dabbling a little bit in everything, it opens your mind, it allows your body to do different things, and then when you start creating your own artistry, it's just so much more spectacular. Guys, check out my other videos. You will have plenty to choose. And please hit that subscribe button. You have to do that to show your support. And I hope to get some comments from you too.